just to set your expectations, I'm not jumping from that tower today. And I'm not jumping from that tower either. I am going up there, and frankly, I've seen the route I've got to take. It looks terrifying enough, but that 20 meter platform is twice the height of the tallest Olympic standard board. If I jump from up there, I'd hit the water at about 70 kilometers an hour. That's easily enough speed that with no training, I would be in hospital. I've even got to be harnessed in while I'm up there, just in case. But that doesn't apply to Lisanne Richard, world-class high diver and cliff diver, who is going to show me the way up and then take the quick route down. And down here, safely at pool level, someone from the Montreal Olympic Park's team is going to explain why they built a board that high.
It's the biggest aquatic center in Canada. It's a facility that was built for the Olympics back in 1976. And it's also right now home of Team Canada in many sports. It's also open to the public.
How long have you been training to be able to do this sort of thing?
I did gymnastic and diving and surface before, but it's been already 22 years that I'm a high diver.
And you were Cirque du Soleil, right?
Yes, I worked with Cirque du Soleil for a while, but I never did diving with Cirque du Soleil.
Okay.
It was completely renovated in 2015. Lisanne was well aware of the Olympic Center. She was also training here. So when we renovated, she looked at all the space here and she said, maybe you could put a high diving platform there. And we started with an 18 meter platform. Then 2 years later, she said, well, you know, I think you guys got room for a 20 meter platform. So we built a 20 meters platform and we became the only place in North America when people can perform high diving in an interior space. Winter can be harsh sometimes, but because we have this facility, they can train all year long.
So how do you learn to do this? Because do you just like work up from lower heights and...
Yeah, you do not do high diving because somebody asks you.
Right.
Like you really have to feel that you have to do it, you know? So just right here.
Okay, up the ladder. Oh, I can feel the positive pressure. The heat, there's air coming up through here.
Yeah, so this is the last chance of change your mind.
No, it's fine. I'm going to be harnessed in. It's okay.
Yeah.
Let's go.
The structure that is here was built initially because people needed to have access to change the lights. The 12 and the 15 meters is attached to the platform that we have right here. But the 20 meter is attached through the roof.
I've got to be harnessed in up here with a lot of stuff. You just have a safety loop.
Because I'm an acrobat, I have the authorization to go only with the hand loop.
Right, let's go. Oh, this platform bounces.
This make it solid.
Yes, because if it bends, it's not gonna break. All right.
Yeah, you are 15 meter up from the floor.
Okay, lead the way. So how many times a day can you do this? It's got to be a physical strain.
Yeah, I do more of the complementary training than high diving because I'm 41. At one point, I had enough impact on my body. So now I train everywhere else and I do high diving to perform. Depending of your age, of your injury, you can go maximum 6 times by day, but you cannot do every day. And you cannot high dive every month.
It's that much strain on your body?
Yeah, because after high diving, you need a recovery time, you know?
Because you're hitting the water at, what, 70 kilometers an hour, something like that?
Exact. Yeah. But in some of my challenge, I go 27 meters, so it's pretty fast. And here, the water is warm, so it's easier on the body. But when we go outside or in competition...
Oh, you might be cliff diving into cold ocean.
Yeah.
We know that FINA, which is the Federation of Aquatic Sports, are working towards having this sport in the Olympics. So we said, well, we might as well have the equipment. We also did the same thing with skateboarding. We also have a big ball. So the goal here is to say after 45 years, how can we be in the game and be also a place where athletes still come train 45 years later?
This is the 15 meter.
This is brand new. Now we have 15
yeah.
to build up the next high diving generation.
Wow.
So there's the 10, yeah. 12, 15, 18, and 20. It makes it really safe because they do not learn too fast and have accidents.
Olympic Games last only 2 weeks. So what's happening when you pay like more than $1 billion for Olympic facilities? You need to think about the future.
You have a zip wire.
Yeah, zip line for this. And I also always put the shoes down. Okay.
That's just fun, that is. That's...
I'm always jealous of my shoes. I would like to go.
Oh, yeah.
We are able to be a place where they can practice, but we can also host some competition, which is quite nice for a facility that was built 46 years ago.
This is the one bit where I'm not harnessing.
Yeah.
Okay, there we go. You're entirely unharnessed. And I've got twin tails on. All right.
But you know, when we dive, it's better to be unharnessed.
Yeah, it is. Okay. I guess that's the one question I haven't asked, which is why? Why did you choose to take this up?
At the beginning, I wanted to do it because I felt brave and I wanted to be one of the men. Because at the beginning, no women were doing this sport, you know? So I wanted to prove that women, we can make it. Then at one point, I wanted to do it to help the sport progress and goes to the Olympic and help to build, to have a next generation and to win. But now I do not need to compete anymore. I want to inspire the people for being involved into the progress of the sport. I'm totally in the present moment when I do high dive. And I'm a mom, I have 3 kids, I have a lot of job. When I high dive, there is nothing. No grocery list, nothing.
So I now just duck under here. Haha. I'm harnessed in. I've got 2 separate harness points. All right.
This is where champions are built, right here, in those facilities, which are also accessible to everybody.
I don't want to distract her at this point, but when you're up here, you do realize that's a very long way down. I'd applaud, but my hands are a bit busy. Right, I'm gonna take the slow route down. It's safer.